the last type of model selection we'll look at is model search. I think these are the most powerful methods of detecting your network structure, but they're also the hardest, so they take a very long time. And the idea in model search is to really search through the model space until we get to a local optimal model. So for example, here, we add an edge, we add another edge, we add another edge, and then we might say, okay, this is where we stop. So we can use extensive model search strategies to find the best model. This usually uses unregularized estimation. So what we do is we just constantly refit the model using maximum likelihood estimation, but with having a certain parameters fixed to zero, having certain edges fixed to zero. So in this case here, we fit this model here, but this edge here is fixed to zero. And there are many different ways which you can do this. So the simplest form would be a step-up algorithm. And one of it is implemented in the Psychonetics package in the step-up function. And there we use modification indices from structural equation modeling to see which edge would be the best to add to a network. Then we add that and we keep doing that until we optimize the BIC. But there are also more advanced stepwise model search algorithms, which are implemented in the model search function for Psychonetics and the GTM mod select function in QGraph. And I'll talk a bit about these. And these are not the only model search algorithms. There are also a few other ones that are implemented, for example, the GTM non-reg package. And you can think of these functions yourself as well to do that. So I'll only talk about a few, but it's not. There are other alternatives as well. The main downside is that this can be slow. It can be really, really, really slow. So get ready to get a bit sleepy and get tired, especially if you have more than like 25 nodes or so, then these algorithms can be extremely slow. So let's look at step-up model search in Psychonetics. So that we can do with this step-up function. So first, what we can do is we can specify omega to be empty. So by default, your network in Psychonetics will be fully connected with all edges included. But with saying omega equals empty, we start with an empty model instead, rather than a fully connected model. Then we can use the step-up function to add edges with the best modification index until the BIC is no longer improved. So we just keep adding the edge that according to the modification is the best, until the BIC is optimized. And this is a very exploratory tool. It uses modification indices, which have a bit of a bad rap in SEM. So I always want to explain that as well. Like modification indices are just a very useful tool to show you, okay, this edge, if you add that, you improve to fit the most. In SEM, people like to do confirmatory analysis. So they like to fit the model. Then the model doesn't fit. Then they secretly look at modification indices, add some parameters, and then the model does fit, but then you're basically doing fraudulent research, right? Because you actually did exploratory research because you looked at modification indices. So that's why modification indices have a bad rap in SEM. Here, we already are doing exploratory research, right? Unless you actually had a prior theory about the network structure and you fitted, which you can do also with this omega argument in Psychonetics. So we're already doing that. So that is less of an issue. And this gives an algorithm that we can look at if it's stable or not, or if it gives us many false positives. And if you simulate under this algorithm by stopping at the BIC, it's quite conservative and it stops doesn't include many false edges as well. So this works quite well. And this will basically start with an empty network and then add edges until we have a good model. The only downside is it is very slow because we start with an empty network. If you count all the edges that were included here, that is quite a lot. So get ready to be a bit sleepy if you do this. A faster way to do this in Psychonetics is to instead start with a fully connected network. So here we now don't specify omega equals empty. And then we add the prune function as well. So we do a prune and then step up model search. So we combine these two functions. That's something we can do. Right, so now we first remove all edges that are not significant. And maybe here now you want to do like also a Bonferroni correction, something like that. And then follow that up with step up. So then you have all the main things already included in one go. And then you can do step up search to add the other things. And you can also think of longer combinations. You can do like prune, step up, prune, step up, prune, step up, for example, to get a really powerful estimation algorithm. This will improve the prune because it will add edges back to the model that you have removed with pruning that you might not have wanted to remove after all in the end. So it will be better, it will be faster. It's still quite slow, of course, because it still does step-up estimation. Now, based on this, in the Psychonetrics package, there is a new method which is quite a bit more advanced than this version, which uses the same ideas of p-values and modification indices to reach the final network. And that is this model search algorithm. So this model search algorithm is implemented in Psychonetrics and you can use it for any model. And this is a very complicated algorithm, but the idea is very simple. It uses p-values and modification indices to iteratively reach an optimal algorithm model. So what do? We first start with a pruned model. So we start with a fully connected network and then remove all edges that are not significant. And then basically we just iteratively add and remove edges using p-values and modification indices until BSE is optimized. So where in step-up we only added one edge every time because we added this edge with the highest modification index. Here, we simply look at all edges that can be removed that are not significant and all edges that can be added because they have significant modification indices, fit all those models, and then pick the best, add one edge or remove one edge, then do all of that again. So where step-up just adds one edge, refit, add one edge, refit, done. This will try 20, 30 edges, for example, pick one, change that, then try 20 edges again, pick one, change that. And then it's implemented that it will zoom in a bit, so it will not refit all edges all the time, but it will zoom in a bit on the edges that were improving BSE already in the previous iteration as well, to be a little bit faster, but it's still very, very slow. So that's the idea. If you want to see the full algorithm, you can pause here and look at the full algorithm if you like. Okay, so that's the idea of model search. And how do we do that in Psychonetrics? Basically we use this model search function. So here we say prune first. That's not implemented in model search itself, so you have to do that manually. And then we say model search, and then it will do this automatically for us. And this thing has some algorithms arguments as well, such as the alpha that you want to look at to see if you want to include or remove edges or not. And if you want to use AIC rather than BSE, things like that. The only downside is that it's very slow, right? So this is actually probably the slowest algorithms of the ones that I discuss here, because this will really go over all possible combinations of edges that you can add or remove. It's much slower than step up, but it's also much better than step up because step up will only look at the best modification index, where model search will look at all possible edges that you can include with a significant modification index. So that's the model search algorithm, and you can also use this for other methods in Psychonetrics, such as the panel data model as well, which we talk about in a later video. Then finally, there is another algorithm that's implemented in the QGraph package, which is actually the main algorithm that I've been using now to estimate Gaussian graphical models, and that is the GGM mod select algorithm, or Gaussian graphical model mod select algorithm. And that's also a very complicated algorithm. It's very similar to model search in Psychonetrics. In fact, model search is derived from the GGM mod select algorithm, but this does not use Psychonetrics, but rather it uses GLASSO to estimate the model. Now GLASSO, as we learned before, is a regularization technique. And the nice thing about GLASSO is that you can also fit a model with a predefined structure with zeros. So I say, okay, I want this edge there, this edge not there, without regularization. So it does a bit of both. And then you do maximum likelihood estimation with using GLASSO, which is a nice thing that it does. So the trick in GGM mod select is that we actually start with GLASSO. So we start by running GLASSO to estimate 100 models, just like we do in the EBSE GLASSO. But then what we do is we have this range of 100 models. In EBSE GLASSO, we use those network estimates to obtain the EBIC. In the GGM mod select, we don't do that, but rather we refit the model. We refit the the model for each of these obtained networks without regularization. So we use GLASSO to fit the structure, but we don't use the regularized parameters anymore. We obtain new parameters with maximum likelihood estimate animation, so we don't have biased estimates of the parameters anymore. So we only use GLASSO for structure, but not for the parameters themselves. And that turns out to be a very powerful thing. If you select a network based on EBDSC on unregularized estimates, then it works better than regularized estimates, especially with large sample size. That's a very powerful thing to do. Now, if we do stepwise equals true as well, then we do this whole second part, where we also then afterwards test all possible edges. And the GLASSO is much faster in estimating a network without regularization with fixed structure than psychonetrics, so this goes relatively fast. So we test all possible edges if they can be removed or added. Then we see if removing or adding one edge improves fit. After that, we add that edge or remove that edge. Then we retest all edges that could have improved fit before. We do that until there's no edge left. Then we retest all edges again. We keep doing that until we really have no edge that can be added or removed to improve the fit of the model. So we reach a local optimum where we are absolutely sure that we cannot add or remove a single edge. Now, of course, it's a local optimum, not a global optimum. So it could be that we can add or remove like 5 edges, and we don't know that. We only test for single edges in that case. But that's the idea behind GDM mod select. If you don't do stepwise, if you do stepwise equals false, you only do this first part where you use GLASSO, but then unregularize the estimates and get pick a model. So it's an unregularized method for estimating the model that has some very strong benefits, much better false positive rate, for example, but also some downside that you no longer have these nice regularized parameters that can clear up your picture with. But with stepwise equals true, you have this long extended stepwise procedure as well. Okay, so what does it look like? Well, we can use it in estimate network in BootNet, like we've done so far a lot. And now I simply use default equals GDM mod select. And here I also used Spearman correlations because why not? We can do that. Just to show that you can do that, actually. The only downside is that this is very slow still, right? So be prepared to tumble a bit and sleep because this might be very slow. Especially if you want to do bootstrapping methods afterwards, that can be extremely slow. So I would not recommend doing the stepwise estimation GDM mod select with, let's say, more than 30 nodes. It gets extremely slow because you're really looking over all possible combinations. You can do GDM mod select without stepwise estimation. So now I put the stepwise equals false, and then it just uses GLASSO. So it's basically very similar to EBC GLASSO. The only difference is it uses the unregularized estimates to pick the model. So you don't have bias in your parameters and the model selection works better, but at the same time, you lose the regularized effect as well. So it's a bit of an upside and a downside. I think the upside is more worth it than the downside, especially at large sample sizes. This is quite fast. This is actually really fast. So it's a form of model selection, but no longer has this stepwise property where you know you're in the local optimum. Okay, so model search. So some benefits. It has very good performance, sensitivity, and specificity. These models seem to be very conservative, but also powerful. So you have high sensitivity, high specificity. Sensitivity, of course, is a bit lower than EBSC GLASSO or other methods. So you still need a lot of samples to pick up all edges, but it is quite well. It can converge to the true model. That's a really nice property, is that these model selection algorithms can actually, an infinite sample size, you can obtain the true model. If you do pruning or thresholding, that's not necessarily the case because you have this fixed false positive rate. So that's a bit of a problem. Also, if your true model is an empty model, with pruning and thresholding, you still include 5% false positives, but here you can get rid of them again. So that's kind of nice about this. You don't have biased estimates and you can reach a local optimum where you're sure that at least in this network, I could not add or remove a single edge to improve fit. But the downside, of course, is very, very slow, especially for large networks, and you don't have the regularization anymore. So that means that the edges that are false are included might be very prominent in your network as well. Okay, and that's it for all the algorithms on model selection. And in the next video, I'll talk about which one you should use.